Hey everyone, welcome back to our course on rapid wireframing. My name is Billy Carlson. I'm a design educator here at Balsamiq. All right, so for this video, we're going to walk through really quickly the design brief and some other research materials that we have ready to help us get started with our wireframes. So we're going to be building a better version of a food ordering kiosk that you'd find at any food hall or food court. And our objective is to design and develop a user-friendly, intuitive, and fast in-store food ordering application to be used on kiosks throughout the food hall. The app should reduce queue times, enhance the customer experience, and maximize food hall efficiency. Getting your customers ordered, get them fed, and have them be happy. One of the things that I like about having a brief here is it allows me to have a clear understanding of what I'm going to be building. The reason why I like this, I think this is a great quote from Carolyn Chandler. It says, one of the keys to a great project is to start the team out with a clear project objective and a well-understood approach. And that's what I hope to do through this video course. So what I have here is an application map. It's similar to what we would build for a website, which is called a site map. So the stickies in yellow are what we're going to focus on in this course. And the stickies in blue might be our second iteration or something that we would release at a later date. So we're going to start with a landing screen. So when you walk up to the kiosk, it has something in there directing you to begin ordering. You know, for the owners of this food hall, it could have things like sales and anything to promote and market the food hall or restaurants within it. But right now, we'll just have a simple landing screen with the logo and the get started button. Once we get started, you'll have a list of restaurants. And then once you dive into a restaurant, you'll see a menu of that restaurant. And then if you tap on a menu item, you get the detail of that, which you can then add to your cart, which we have here. And then after you've added all your items to your cart, you can go to checkout. And then once you use the checking out, you'll get an order confirmation. So that's what we're going to design today. I also worked on a user flow just to make sure I really understood what it's like. And I understood exactly all the screens I'm going to be designing for. So we have a landing screen, like I talked about, the list of restaurants. You choose one. This is what a restaurant would look like. A landing page with the menu on it. I'm assuming it'll just be one full page so that you could scroll through and easily order. A menu item detail screen. A modal once you've added that item, and then the ability to either go back to that same restaurant or order from a different restaurant. We don't want to make it difficult for our customers to only order one. The great thing about going to a food hall is they have 10 to 12 different restaurants. What I'm hoping to do is design an application that allows you to order from three of them if you want. After that, if you finished building your order, you can review it in the order review screen, and then you can go through that and check out. And then you pay. And here we have the customer journey map where we try to think through that user flow and what the customer is experiencing when using it. So we have the pre-order, which means that they'll walk into a food hall and have to find a kiosk to order from. Outside of the digital realm, which we're designing, we're going to also have to design things in the real world to help people get to the kiosk. So once they're ordering, hopefully it'll be an easy experience for them to understand and go through. Payment hopefully will be very simple. That's what we're going to design for. Finding a table, food pickup. What ways could we design it to make it easy for our users to know when their order is ready and know where to go to pick it up? Hopefully the food will be delicious. And then what do you do when you leave? These are all things we can think about when we're designing a digital application, but also when we're working with our client to understand the entirety of the customer experience. Our next step now is to start designing our screen. So what we'll do is make a copy of this. I'm going to add a new wireframe. I'm going to put this in here just so I know what I'm designing for. And I'm going to do what I call really low fidelity wireframe sketches of some of these pages just to get a sense of, you know, what I should be designing for. So I'm going to actually try and use only key commands. So the stuff that we talked about earlier, and think of this as like a digital whiteboarding exercise or sketching with a Sharpie and a piece of paper. So What I want to do is, okay, I'm thinking landing screen, list of restaurants. Those are pretty easy. So probably do the, I want like a logo for the restaurant. Probably a sign-in button here. And then maybe some text like, it should be just that simple. All right, and the kiosk, they generally are like this portrait mode, so I'll make it this size, and I will send that back. And that is Command Shift down on the keyboard, and that could literally be it. Now, if I can change this color and go here, and like the button, let's just say it's bright orange, and that's my let's get started. So what I'm going to do is copy this. Probably copy that too. And I'm going to hold on to the option key and slide over. Now this will be our list of restaurants. What I'm going to do is put a heading up here, something bigger that I can sort of control, but think of it as a welcome message for the restaurants and drag that down a little bit. And then I'm thinking I would just want probably three restaurants. That makes sense. I like to do odd numbers of things. It's very common in the art design, the visual design world to use odd numbers when laying out multiple items because there's always something in the middle. It's very symmetrical that way. So I'm just going to guess that there's around, let's say there's 12 restaurants. The spacing doesn't have to be perfect, but we'll get there. Let's say that there's lucky number 11, just so we have an odd number. What I like to do is get the spacing right. So I first just use these up here. Right here, this is going to be your like distributing it vertically. And this is horizontally, which means left and right. So making everything even in the center or between them. So when I click between them, you could see. Now there's all these different ways you can do it, but I like to keep it simple and just drag them a little bit so that they're all lined up. It looks pretty even. And that to me is pretty much all I would need for this page. I might have a box here having my navigation starting already. Now this is my list of restaurants, so I could do a restaurant sort of menu or actually a landing page for a restaurant. And we'll keep following the structure because, okay, that's the name of the restaurant. I don't need all these. I can just pick one. Let's say this is the logo, some sort of imagery at the top. This is the title of the restaurant. What I can do is use this to make it a little smaller because hierarchy, some sort of promotional image. Now we can probably show images of the menu, but also maybe start with a list of specials. I like to make things asymmetrical when it's like that. To show it could be real text, right? So maybe this is a list of specials. One thing I think would be important too, but like categories, I like having categories. So maybe we can keep the categories here. My idea would be because this is a touch screen is that you can swipe through left and right like a carousel. So I'll just kind of hint that there's more on this side and these can have text in them. But right now I'll just use a color inside to show that they're different. Okay. So I'm thinking specials, I'm thinking categories, title of restaurant, some sort of restaurant imagery here. I would say that maybe this is actually like a section for food. So say this is appetizers and this could be, I like doing these little card designs. I'm going to change that back to white and then I'm going to copy this, but have a slim little image here. I just see this design pattern a lot. If you go to all the popular food ordering sites, they sort of do this. One side has the image, the other side has details of what you're ordering. And we can just do that. And now I'm sort of hinting at this cart design to see if I like it later. So this could be a restaurant landing page. Maybe it's not perfect. I think this is my back button. I'll probably color this something a little different just for now. I still need to think through my navigation, but right now that is a listing of a restaurant. And then let's make the menu item detail. So this would probably be the name of the item that you want to order. I want to be able to customize everything. And I also want an add to cart button. I think that's super important. So the imagery will be important too. So let's make that a little bigger. This is what you're going to get. These can serve as the customization options, and maybe how we can highlight that is by adding some check marks. So I'm going to move this over a little bit and just add tiny little squares, little baby squares. Let's see how small we can go with these. That's about it. 10 by 10 is perfect. I'm going to zoom in. I'm going to hold on to the option key on my keyboard and just drag it down, and that made a copy. And then if I hit Command or Control D a few times, automatically duplicates it for me. That's what D stands for. So now what I'm gonna do is line them all up, use this again, which basically makes the distance between each object the exact same. Way to go, math. And then I'll hold on to the Option key, drag them over, and now I have a checkbox. So the idea for me is if I wanna order, let's say, a hamburger, but I don't want cheese, or I do want cheese, right? And lettuce, tomato, whatever the toppings are. You could do the same thing for pretty much anything you order. And we want them to get what they want, so we can just have that. Okay, so what I want to do here is add the price onto the image. This is a common pattern in e-commerce cards that you'll see, and I'll show you some examples. What we want to do here is make this sort of little area stand out over whatever imagery we have. You know, orange might be okay. Orange is our call to action button. Whatever secondary color we have here, something to use to make it stand out. And then we'll just put a little text in here, something that makes it easy for our users to see the price clearly and quickly. Obviously, this is a wireframe that might be too big, but the idea here is you'll read the title of the menu item, you'll see an image, you'll see the price, you can customize it, add to cart. Something that I want to do is select the quantity, which is pretty common when you're purchasing food items online. You may want to order two. So how we do that is a pretty easy, I would suggest a stepper for something in the food realm where you're going to only order maybe 1 through 5. So what we can do is put it right on top of the add to cart button. So the order of how you view the screen would be what you're going to order, the image, the price, customizations, and then add to cart. And before that, you can select quantity. So let's draw like these little stepper boxes, and they just need plus and minus as text, which is easy. I can either just use text, do it this way, and then just the number in the middle, which will make larger, and so it stands out. And that's really it. It's just as simple as that. So now I feel like if you looked at the screen, you'd understand how I want it to eventually work. And what we're doing again is sketching. So let's just keep going. Let's continue. I think for cart, I kind of want to use something like a combination of these to list out what I'm ordering. Plus, I want to be able to change the quantity and add it to cart. So I'll copy this up here. And I think what I'm going to do is keep this. I'm going to group this. So I selected everything. And I'm going to go to Edit, Group. You can use Command or Control G. And I just put them a little closer together because I'm going to move them up here. So that's gone. We're going to need the price. This doesn't really need to be here. That's just going to say cart. Okay. And these would be the items I'm ordering. Kind of want to make sure that I can change the quantity. So I'm going to have price and quantity for each. It's pretty standard stuff, right? Here's all the listings. I could possibly use this design, but for right now, this seems to work for me. Cart, list of items I've added, quantity, basically go to checkout from here. And then checkout, I think is just going to be very simple form, right? Which I can build. This will be the title. This will be navigation. And I intentionally do this so that I line these up in this very specific way so I can copy across the board, across the canvas, and add what I want and move faster. Checkout's just usually a series of form fields, right? Where they want to get your information to allow you to pay and continue on. So I'll break it up by a few things. The standard would be, you know, your name, your phone number. If it's e-commerce, it's your email. Since this is in-store, it'll be your phone number. And I would like to do is text you when your order is ready. So this would be personal information, and this would be payment information. And then that's it. What we have here now is a really rough set of wireframes that hold all the information we need for the user to use the product, and I can take these and bring them into high fidelity, or I can start exploring more options.
Okay.
What I want to do is focus on exploring different designs for these three screens. These two screens, this would be your cart and your checkout. I don't want to do anything other than what I would say is very traditional pages of a listing for my cart and form fields for my checkout. These three pages here can be designed in different ways to improve usability, to walk up and just easily understand how to interact with them. There's lots of different ways those pages can work and still be effective. These pages are very traditional. They have established design patterns. I don't want to change them too much from what all of us would expect to see on a cart and on a checkout page or screen. Okay, so I'm just going to do a few options and that's it. All right, welcome back. So what I did really quick, as you saw, is I designed two more iterations for each screen. And what I like to do is just not settle for the first idea and kind of think through different ways the screen could work. These are just different styles that I'm familiar with. These are card styles, and you know, we have a horizontal and a vertical. And just playing around with how it feels and just looking at it. I'm going to maybe add some space so we can stare at each iteration. What I want to do now is just decide which one I think I want to move forward with. And again, the way that this is designed, as you can see, it's following similar patterns across. And that's intentional because I don't want my designs to have totally different patterns on each screen. They should be very familiar. And I think I achieved that. So what I want to do is I'm going to go ahead and select a few. And then in the next video, I'm going to turn these thumbnail type wireframes into more of a mid-fidelity that I can add real content to and see how they look and feel. And when I complete that, I can decide to create different UI variations like I did here in the thumbnail, or I can go straight to showing people my designs and getting their feedback. All right, see you next video.